Welcome back to Let's Play Vampire the Masquerade Bloodlines. Blind. We're going to talk to Rodriguez. But I assume he's in one of those doors. We got some people out here we can talk to as well. What's this say? I can't see it when I'm down like that. Red Diver Ale? Is there really ale in there? Okay, let's talk to her. What does her shirt say? You heard that? Army Troika. Cool. You sound mad.
It's about chase you in here, Cammy.
What are you talking about?
Heard Nine saved your ass again. You think LaCroix would have stopped counting his money long enough to get your back, Jack?
I thought it was LaCroix. She says LaCroix. I know what she means by again. It actually is the second time. I could have handled that myself.
What were you gonna break out, huh? Some Tybo? This ain't paintball with your jerk-off friends on the weekend, Cammy. It's the mean streets. Show some goddamn gratitude.
What's with the attitude?
Oh, you want to know what my problem is? All right, I'll tell you what my problem is.
Go ahead.
You are my goddamn problem. Anyone who would lay it down for some cape in an ivory tower deserves what they get.
Cape?
Cape, Cammy. Camarilla elders. The ones that have been around so long they think candlelight's a keen invention. You're doing their dirty work and you don't even know it.
What alternative do I have?
You want an alternative? Being here, that's a step in the right direction. I'm Damsel, Denmother of these mothers, and one pissed bitch since LaCroix lived in.
Now she said LaCroix. Maybe I heard her wrong the first time. I don't know about LaCroix. I'm cool with Nines, though.
Hey, Cammy. I don't apologize often, but it's just with all the shit that's been going down lately. And on top of it, this plague bearer getting the CDC's attention, maybe I misjudged you, is all I'm saying.
Plague bearer? CDC? Center for Disease Control? Understandable. Please tell me what a plague bearer is.
A plague bearer's a fool that doesn't care who they feed from. Yeah, I know what you're thinking. We can't get sick, but the kind can. And kindred that feed on them start spreading disease. When that gets sick, it's an epidemic. CDC's in town as we speak.
Oh, that's what those two guys with the hazmat suits are standing there. Is it really that dangerous to be in town here that they need to be wearing those suits? How do you get rid of a plague bearer? So how do you get rid of one?
Seen Old Yeller? May sound cruel, but it's necessary. If someone puts together two and two as to the real cause of an outbreak of bloodborne diseases, guess what happens? So the plague bearer's gotta be found and put down. If the Camarilla really gives a damn, they'll help us out.
I'll do it only because I'm bored. The Anarchs helped me out before. Where do I start?
One of our boys, Ghouls. Name's Paul. Lives nearby in the Skyline Apartments. Been a stranger lately. Looked like death last time he was here. Said he didn't get bit, but maybe you can get more info out of him.
Ghouls. Why is it always ghouls? Fine, I'll check it out when I can.
Wait. If Paul's not talking, you might want to start questioning the homeless Pop. So many have been dying lately that it takes the city a few days to pick up the bodies.
Okay, so now we got two things. Two reasons to go to Skyline Apartments. Before I go, I have a question.
Yeah?
Tell me about Nines.
No one like him in this world or the next. He's to the Anarchs what George Washington was to the colonies, what Ho Chi Minh was to Vietnam. He is the L.A. Anarchs personified. He's a great leader, and yet he's humble. I die for him.
I owe him my life. Seems like one of the only decent people I've met yet.
No one like him in the Camarilla or otherwise. Anything else?
Your thoughts on LaCroix? Get ready.
Who the hell does he think he is coming into town claiming Camarilla authority over the city? We kicked them out 60 years ago. It's like England coming back and telling the U.S. how they should do things. Fuck LaCroix.
I had no idea the Anarchs had been in control that long. I had another question.
Yeah?
Tell me about Smiling Jack.
Jack? Jack's Jack. Kind of a legend amongst Anarchs. There's not an Anarch in the world who wouldn't stand in rock star awe of Jack. Even the Camarilla doesn't mess with him.
Wow. Really? I had no idea. Jack's one of the cooler people I've met.
He's been around a long time. He used to be a pirate, so the rumor goes. Talk to Jack. He's never short on chat.
Yeah, I just finished talking to him before I came up here. I had another question.
Yeah?
Your thoughts on the Camarilla? Let's see if there's anything else she hasn't said about them yet.
It's a sham. A pyramid scheme. Nothing but musty, withdrawn elders waging power struggles for no other reason than to keep their own ass alive for one more century. You think you have any real power in the cam? You're kidding yourself.
I really don't understand it myself. I'm kind of new to this.
You'd be better off without them. You'll see. Yeah?
Tell me about the Anarchs.
We are about passion, Cammy, and freedom. Things most Camarilla types just can't understand. I could go on and on, but Skelter says it takes too long to get me off my soapbox. Ask him. Or even Jack.
Nah, go on. Tell me what you think.
I mean, geez, it just makes sense. Power should be redistributed amongst all of us, not just a few. Communism would actually work for Kindred, where it fails with humans. It's just common sense, you know?
Hmm. You gotta stand over there, but keep talking, I'll be listening. See, it is like politics. I mean, you've got democracy, communism here for the Anarchs. Or complete anarchy, I guess, depending on who you're talking to. Alright. I got a question about something else?
Yeah?
Nothing right now. Excuse me.
Hey, I heard that.
I said excuse me. Too polite for you? Hi.
You showed up. Good. Here's what I gotta tell you.
Oh, you are
so
nice.
You know, I don't lecture, I don't rap, I'm no bureaucrat. I'm just a guy out of nowhere came to be involved in something 500 times bigger than you and me.
I thought it was someone else. Sorry, guys. You're probably laughing at the end of the last video. He's standing right there. And he looked different from over there. Alright. Just a guy out of nowhere came to be involved in something 500 times bigger than you and me. Go on.
You got a right to know the score. The Camarilla, this is the short of it. They operate a lot like a pyramid scheme. There's a bunch of these old-timers at the top with God only knows what plots in mind. They lose their power, they die. They sired more to carry out their plans. And looking for a little power, then those kindred sired for their own schemes, and so on and on and on. It hurts my head just thinking about the mess. What it works out to is this. Only a few people at the top have any real power.
Aren't you part of the Camarilla?
Them's fighting words, newbie. But you're young and stupid, so I won't make an example out of you. See, the Camarilla claims all of us are members, even if we don't want to be. Which is, of course, the biggest little horseshit a man ever heard.
Yeah, no, he's Anarch. So what are you all about?
I learned the way of this world during the Depression. Bunch of old rich bastards screwed the country. But did they suffer? No. The little people suffered. You can't trust the people at the top. The world would be a better place without them. All you can do is get a group of people together who aren't assholes. Find a place to put your feet up and make some examples of the quote-unquote elite to keep the rest the hell out. Everyone's an equal here. The same thing this country used to be about. That's what LA has been. An anarch-free state.
Anarch-free state?
The Camarilla was kicked out on their ass a long time ago. We, the Anarchs, didn't want to play their politics anymore. Now LaCroix and crew pop in like they never left? Uh-uh. No goddamn way. Their laws don't apply to us.
Have you tried meeting with the Camarilla?
I got their meeting right here.
Okay. Not a fan of the prince, huh?
LaCroix represents everything I hate. The Camarilla, stuck-up aristocrats, rich businessmen, crooked politicians. The only place LaCroix belongs is in an urn.
Hmm. Yeah, don't turn number two. Don't go there. Sounds like you're the prince of the anarchs.
No such thing. And again, newbie, don't throw those kind of words around lightly. You're risking a beatdown.
I didn't have a choice.
I've fought to keep LA free since I was embraced. Long time later, I'm one of the only ones left that hasn't bitted or switched sides. The most veteran soldier on the battlefield.
Sorry, I can only choose one or the other. The other one was even worse than that, believe me, Nines. One more question. Actually, I have more than that, but, any advice you can give me?
Here's what I tell all the new blood. One, you get careless, that blood'll make you into a monster. But you rampage around here, you get put down. Two, don't kill when you feed. No reason to. In this city, there's lots of ways to slake the beast without leaving a trail of dead. Three, the Camarilla's full of shit. Four, watch your back, always. And lastly, learn how to fight. Because a speech ain't gonna save your ass when you're staring down the barrel of a shotgun.
No kidding. I've been quite a few encounters where you just can't talk your way out of stuff. Can you teach me how to fight?
After picking your ass up off the pavement back there, yeah. I can tell you don't even know the basics. Hold your hands up like this and keep your body at an angle. Makes you harder to hit. Keep your thumbs out of your fists and put your weight into your punches.
Cool, my stats increased. Probably for hand-to-hand fighting, which I'm never going to use. Thanks for all your help, Nines.
LA's the school of hard knocks, so keep your friends close and your enemies in a barbecue pit. Once you square things with LaCroix, don't give that son of a bitch the time of night. I got my eye on you, kid.
Okay. Anything else to say?
Sorry, newbie, but I got the whole city shouting in my ear right now. We'll have to rant some other night.
Well, seems pretty quiet to me. Does she have anything else to say?
Seth. Yeah?
I know. Alright, let's check out in here. Oh, these are just the bathrooms. Misty. Vesuvius in Hollywood. Everett Mann. Secure area. Reanimated Judas House Studios presents From Heck. Oh, I thought it was blood in there. That would be interesting if it was. Condoms. Oh, they got a window here. Hidden area? Okay. Let me guess, we're gonna have to use that secret way out at some point. This place is gonna be raided by Camarilla or Sabbat or something. No spoilers, guys, if it is. Or isn't. I'll go out the regular way. Let's see if Jack has anything... Let's see if he has anything else new to say.
What's up? Yeah? Yeah? Who do you want to know about?
What's up with this damsel chick?
You mean college girl over there? To be honest, she reminds me of those miserable stateside protester fucks from when I was in Nam. But she's on the right side of this war. Don't let the hippie vibe fool you.
Thanks. I'm gonna ask Jack about her as well.
So I heard you and Nines had a run-in with the Sabbat, huh? And you let them go. Nines must be getting soft. How could you pass up that kind of fun?
How come he keeps helping me?
Well, he was left sireless, too. I don't know, maybe that's it. Well, he's got a thing for the little guy.
How do you think the Sabbat found me?
Someone must have put a word out. Now, here's an interesting little scenario. I'm just gonna run this by you, see what you think. What if the Prince got the word out to the Sabbat that you were the one to blow up their warehouse?
You really think that's possible? And he's the one who told me to do it.
Hey, it's just a theory, man, but who else is gonna be watching you so closely, knowing where you're going and all that?
Why would LaCroix help the Sabbat?
I'm not saying he's working with the Sabbat. I know he ain't. But he sure as hell could have put the word out there on the street where the Sabbat would pick up on it. Gonna just chew on that.
I guess I wouldn't put it past him.
It's how the Camarilla works, kiddo. Trust me. I've been dealing with these slimy shits for a few centuries now. Sure thing, kiddo. Fire away.
I just want to see if this leads to Damsel.
That's us, so I'm told. What do you want to know?
Pasta, who's your leader, Nines?
As much as anyone is. Nine?
Yeah,
I'm not sure the story on most of them. Nine's crew.
Peace. I guess we're done in the last round. She said we might want to ask the homeless some things.
You got what? Hands.
Get away from me! Leave me alone!
I need to ask you about the sickness that's been plaguing the homeless.
Oh, you do? Well, I don't believe you. You're after my aluminum cans, aren't you? But you're not gonna get them. Just get away!
I don't want your aluminum cans. I don't have that much money right now. It's gonna be a fifth of my money if I give her 20 bucks. If you don't start talking, I'm going to recycle you.
Okay, all I know is that old Tin Can Bill, he's been jabbering about some kind of monster that took him somewhere and got him sick. And that's all I know, okay? And that's all I'm saying.
Where is this Tin Can Bill?
Well, you can usually find him down in his alleyway, just across from that bar over there.
Thanks. See ya.
Anybody got a menorah?
A menorah.
Get away from my stuff.
I don't want your stuff. Okay, new quests. A helpful homeless person has pointed out Tin Can Bill as a possible link in the Plague Bearer chain. He can be found in the alley across from the last round. Fun with pestilence. Attention, whore. Skelter wants you to make Patty disappear. She's a ghoul who's been bugging everyone about her master and won't believe them when they tell her he's dead. Not only is she getting tiresome, Skelter is concerned about the implications for the masquerade if she keeps shooting her mouth off. She can usually be found whining at the club confession to anyone unfortunate enough to talk to her. Oh, so confession isn't a church or something. It's an actual club. That's cool to be going to Chinatown and Hollywood at some point. Alright. So he should be down from this bar? That guy? Tin Can Bill? Is that you?
Crab nipple!
Oh, you're a crab nipple guy. Oh. Hi. Is it you? Yep.
Who's there, huh? Old Bill can't see too good these days. Is that you, Betty? I ain't got no booze tonight, so you may as well get the hell out of here.
It's not Betty. I was actually saying that before it popped up. It's not Betty, Bill. I heard that you can tell me why everyone is getting so sick.
Yeah, I might be able to. But I'm awful thirsty tonight, miss. Would you spare $5 for a man who's been down on his luck?
Kind of job, really? Sure, here's $5.
Thank you much. I'm going to have to go pick up some hooch.
Knock yourself out. Literally.
For medicinal purposes, you know.
Whatever.
Now, I know you ain't going to believe old Bill, because I've been telling my friends and the cops and everyone since it happened. And people just say that it's the hooch talking and nothing more.
It's all right. I'll believe you, Bill.
It was a monster, you see. Monster with his face all twisted and ugly. Teeth longer than your finger.
Nosferatu?
Eyes piss yellow and full of hate. I've never seen eyes like that before. Still giving me bad dreams.
So? What happened?
He grabbed me, threw me over his shoulder, took me to the bad place. The dark place. Oh, God. The smell. Worse than anything I've... And then he bit me. My neck. Oh, God. It was horrible. Don't remember too much after that. Blacked out and woke up here in my alley. Haven't been feeling too well since then.
Hmm. Bill, I need to know where the monster took you.
Came up through the sewers, he did.
Nosferatu.
Just around the corner there. Don't want to go back to the bad place, friend. Don't let the monster come back and take me there.
Bill, stay with me. Everything's gonna be alright. Don't worry, Bill. Someone's gonna pay for this. What? He's dead? He died. After telling me all his story just like that. Alright. I'm not going in here yet. I want to talk to the guy in Skyline Apartments first. I realized the guy was going to die like that. I figured he just always coughs and stuff like that. Tin Can Bill has pointed you in the direction of the sewers near where he took his last breath as the possible home of the Plague Bearer. Possible home. Can I talk to this lady again? See who playing?
Jesus, bring me a candle, it's Hanukkah!
Anything down here? This is where we come out that window. Yeah. CDC. So I'm here at the end. The last round and... Oh look, there's a 12. There's an... Oh wait, 11 and 12 is parking, yeah. So what else is nearby? 8? I can't get into the hotel. 7 is the hospital. I can't go in here? I want to pretend to be a toll booth, whatever. Not a toll booth operator, but... No. So this is that hotel we can't get into yet. Anyway. And I've been down here, for sure. Yeah, I've been down here. Hospital should be nearby. Maybe this is it? Well, that's Hellebrook Hotel here. There's another place I can't get into. It's an interesting insignia. Oh! Is this the hospital? Say it's not in very good shape. And what's this? Ooh, look at that up there. It's Doctor Strange's Sanctum Sanctorum. I'm here. I'm by parking and... something. Some kindred believe that a wrecking is the hand of the powers of heaven preparing to... Oh. Oh, this is an Elysium area. Cool. We won't get suddenly get killed. At least we shouldn't. That was spooky as hell, though. What is this? Thaumaturgical creatures. Sweet. Oh, there's her candelabra. It's Halloween. Check this book out. Nothing better than a good old book. Thaumaturgical creatures. E. Bankins, Regent, Chicago. Gargoyles. During the recent... During the medieval conflict with the... Zemessi? How to say that. Clan Tremere delved further into secret blood magic. Ooh, this must be this guy's house. The Regent. Cool, I've been looking forward to meeting him. Get to meet my own Regent. Clan Tremere delved further into secret blood magics and created a race of protectors known as Gargoyles. We created that. That's cool. Since their inception, gargoyles have been used as scouts, warriors, and sentries. Gargoyles are monsters, vampires by virtue of the blood and flesh through which they were created. They are no more than the detritus of other clans, given a second chance to serve their Tremere creators. Unfortunately, many have wrongly come to view their service as slavery and have fled their masters in search of some delusional utopia. Most escaped gargoyles live in isolation, preferring solitude to even the company of their own kind. Homunculi. For the most menial and mindless tasks, many Tremere create what is called a homunculus. These are mindless creatures which take many forms, winged, many-legged, or otherwise. Homunculi are unfailingly loyal, but their appearance makes them a serious threat to breaking the masquerade. Okay. It's not a skill book. I can't read that for points. So yeah, this is a... M. Strauss, the Tremere Regent, is invited to his home in downtown Los Angeles. You need to find him. His invitation left a cryptic riddle which reads, "Dark blood, our curse. Alight this verse. Such power I sense in one so young." Yes, that's me. "Come find me where burns the mystical sun." I didn't spot a mystical sun. Just gonna look outside here really quick. You can raise your humanity like any other character stat by spending experience. Oh! That's cool, I didn't know that. I didn't know that, but rather I'd rather not waste it, I'd rather raise it. Okay, I guess he means that, where it burns that mystical sun. Sweet. And then we've got this, which, that's not a sun. That's a skull. Is that you talking? You sound screwed up, man. Indiscipline's key to shut off a discipline while it's hurting. Alright, let us look around some more. Guessing you might be upstairs. Oh, look at all this! Got spooky little stuff going on. Those look at like important doors. I want to look around more. See if I can find any more books. Oh wait, I just went back here. I'm being teleported. Look at that. I think. Came in that way. It looked like I was getting displaced, teleported. See that? Oh. What's that say? Niv bed? Oh. Guess I'm going through those doors. I'm stuck there for a second. Alright, teleport me back, baby. Whee. Greetings.